my name is Jennifer Munson. I'm the owner of Jennifer Munson Photography. And the question that is asked me is, what tips would you give to somebody who's looking to become an equine photographer? Now, this may sound general, but honestly, there's a lot of people who say, I may just like to photograph horses without really knowing the animal. I think one thing that sets equine photographers apart who truly love horses are just the absolute fact that we know these animals. We understand certain characteristics about them, their behavior, things like that. So you can sort of anticipate what might happen, especially when you're trying to photograph a certain movement. If you know that horse, you're going to know how their body moves, how their legs work, things like that. So that's the first thing that I would recommend. Find a horse, spend as much time as you can with horse people, go to horse shows, do whatever you need to do to get around horses. The second thing you're going to need to do is buy a digital SLR camera. And the reason you're going to need to do that is because you need a camera where you're going to be able to manually control certain things about that camera. And it also lets you change out different lenses. So maybe one day you want to use a fisheye lens, something creative, or you need a wide angle because you're taking photos of, you know, the farm area, and you need to get as much in that photo as possible. And the main thing that you need is a zoom lens. You just can't go without it. A lot of advice that I heard in the beginning was, you know, when you're looking at your budget, say your budget is $4,000. You need to take the biggest part of your budget and you need to put that toward your lenses. Your higher quality lenses make all the difference in photographing, and then save the rest of the budget for the type of camera that you can afford. Another good way to get involved in equine photography, there's something called the Equine Photographers Network. It's where I found a lot of my information. There are so many do's and don'ts that I didn't understand, so many things about my camera that maybe I didn't understand. You can always go to these for information and advice. If you join their professional network, you know, you will often see jobs come through that you can apply for and things like that. Another thing that is essential, know your camera. The worst thing in the world you ever want to do is be on a shoot, you have a malfunction with your camera, you don't know how to fix it, and trust me, that happens. A lot of us have two cameras. In case one malfunctions on the spot and you cannot fix that, you have your backup camera. A lot of it, and I cannot stress this enough, is practice. Practice, practice, practice. You need to get out there every second that you possibly can taking photographs. And if you're looking at doing this as a profession, you may want to look into workshops. If your schedule allows, consider a photography degree. Any kind of education. If you're going back to school, you're going to need to know business advice. You're going to need to take business classes, marketing, because most of us, if not all equine photographers, are freelancers. And what that comes down to is that you work for yourself. And when you work for yourself, you're running your own business, and you need to know how to do that. A lot of us are artists. When it comes to the business end, that's the hardest part for us. So education, practice, the right equipment.